children, how are you all? I hope everyone is fine, safe at home. Okay, today we are discussing about the world during World War. The next topic, the Russian Socialist Revolutions between 1917 and 1923. The Russian Socialist Revolution. So how the Russian Socialist Revolution was happened? Actually, Russia was ruled by, if you take Russia is with the, it spread, it's a vast area spread over with two continents, that is Europe and Asia. Therefore, it had been called as Euro-Asian power. That's why Russia is called as Euro-Asian power. And this in 20th century, Tsars were ruling the country. Now, Tsars were ruling the country. Tsars means we are, generally we say emperors. Emperors were ruling the country. In Russia, they say emperors. In 20th century, Tsars were ruling the country. So, it was a vast country. It spread over two continents, that is Europe and Asia. Therefore, it had been called as Euro-Asian power. Then, it had the third largest population, populated country. This had a third largest population country, Russia. Third largest. Before that, largest population country with 156 million people. 156 million people. And after China and India, China is the first largest country, and next India is second largest populated country, and next is Russia. And it comprises of several nations. Russia is comprised of several nations like Russia, Ukraine, Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, etc. With such nations, the combination of several nations, and this is all called Russia. So such a time, what happened? Generally, from most of the people in Russia came from peasants, agriculture background, and most of the people are from agriculture in Russia, and there was always a conflict between the feudal lords and peasants. The feudal lords were controlling over the lands, and they paid rent to the these people. Peasants were paid rent to what the land they did. So all often there was a struggle between the feudal lords and peasants. And at that time, Tsar Nicholas II ruled the country. Tsar Nicholas II was ruling the entire Russia with the help of military and bureaucrats. Bureaucracy. Who are bureaucrats? Bureaucrats means with some representatives, with a few people, he was ruling the country with the bureaucrats and military. And Russian economy had suffered a loss in the war, during the First World War, because it's the largest country with a lot of population, and most of the Russian soldiers, and 2 million soldiers were died. 2 million soldiers and civilians were died in First World War. So that was the biggest human loss in the world is for Russia only. And after that, a large amount of food was continuously supplied to the in the war front. Then what happened? There was a lot of food shortage and in cities. And so such a time, on March 8, 1917, at the capital city of St. Petersburg, there was a big protest with women, about 10,000 women. They were started a protesting and were demanding the peace and bread. So many people, along with the women, industrial workers, peasants, everyone were supported the protest. So Tsar Nicholas II was really upset with this situation, and he sent army to suppress the protester. And also, he gave an orders to shoot at site orders, and even at firing them. But what happened when the military, instead of after going there, instead of firing them, they also joined in the protest. So there was a big, in 2 days, after 2 days, there was the situation became so worst after 2 days, and Tsar Nicholas II escaped from Russia. He left the throne and escaped from Russia. Then immediately there was a provisional government started. Provisional government started. So here what happened, that is the first revolution in Russia, that is March Revolution 1917. This was the first revolution, that's why it is called March Revolution 1917. Okay, next. Aristocrats and liberates form the government after Tsar Nicholas. Liberates and aristocrats form the government, and they started, they continued the war because of the honor to Russia. They continued the war. But in the October 1917, it was not a spontaneous revolution. It was continued like that. October Revolution, October 1917. Here what happened, the people were completely fed up and they were tired with the military actions and economic shortage in the country, and people were tired and they want an unconditional peace. They demanded for unconditional peace. So slowly they made a provisional government. They all, people are naturally peasants and all, they started a team like called Soviets. These are the Soviets. They started one team like councils. They organizing themselves as teams, and they are called Soviets. The Soviets are, Soviet means the common people power. That is called common people's power. So this common people power, there was a leader started, and he is Vladimir Lenin. And this common people's party is Bolsheviks. These party's name is Bolsheviks. So Bolsheviks leader, he is the founder for the Bolsheviks, are Vladimir Lenin. So everybody, all the communist party people and these founder people, Soviets, everybody supported the Vladimir Lenin and these party. Why? Because they wanted to give an unconditional peace and unconditional peace immediately. Immediately they demanded for unconditional peace. They demanded for unconditional peace. So such a time, immediately what are their demands were, the Bolsheviks were able to get support of the common people, and immediately there was an unconditional peace. And they also started few things. What are that? The first one is, they wanted to nationalization of all the lands. Nationalization of all lands by the government, by the these people, all the lands. And after that, immediately redistributed the lands to whoever needy. Redistributed the land to the needy people or landless laborer. Okay. And the third one is, they wanted control over prices. The third one is control over prices. Control over prices. And then the nationalization of all factories and banks. So this is a very good experiment, nationalization of all factories and banks.
all factories and banks. So what is this nationalization? Generally in socialism, they are towards socialism they are going. So what is socialism? The centralized planning, all the everything, all the natural resources of the country should be in the hands of the government, and it will redistribute to the whoever needy people. So there was no viability, no bias, no, there will be a social equality and all. But these are continuing like this. In October and November 1917, again there was a war, civil war was started. Why this civil war? Because some people are in the side of Russian monarchs, the White Army, and there was a conflict, there was a war between the White Armies and Communist Party leaders. Communist Party means these Bolsheviks, Communist Socialist parties, Communist and Socialist parties. So there was a conflict between these two parties, and finally with the help of Germany, with the help of America, France and Japan, with the help of this, in 1920 they were defeated, the White Armies, and they started the Bolsheviks government. However, these totally everybody's agreement, all the people, whoever, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan and Ukraine, Russia, are all agreed, and they are all under one roof, that is called US. They joined in USSR, that is what, Union of Soviet Socialist Republic. So finally they got independent in 1920, and they are all formed as USSR. What is USSR? Union of Soviet Socialist Republic. And they started a great experiment, is the building a country without any social inequalities. Okay.